going to do something a little bit different on this channel today. I want to do a little bit of fab work stuff. I've got to put 2-10 fittings on this Toyota valve cover. They're going to go where this fitting is here and this one is here. I've already ran this thing through the hot tank. So I'll pull these fittings out, talk to you guys about just the prep process and that kind of thing. If you'd like to see more of these fab videos, please comment or at least like the video so I'll continue to make some of these if you guys want to see more of it. So check it out. So I've never worked on one of these valve covers, so I really don't know how these fittings come out of here. So I'm gonna try to just wiggle this thing out. Oh, check it out. Come right out. All right. This one obviously is just a rubber grommet here. See if I can get that guy to come out of there relatively easy. That one's... more difficult than the last one. Okay, that's rubber grommet out. This is in a goes in a Toyota, an old Tacoma. I think it's like a mid 80s Tacoma. It's a single turbo Haltech deal. It's been in here before and had some crankcase vent issues, which is what we're doing with this. He had some stuff plumbed incorrectly, if I remember right, but... man, I can't get that guy out of there. So hopefully we can get this stuff sorted out, and he will bring the truck back. It's pretty neat. It's nothing too crazy powerful, but it just looks like a good time. You guys know how I like the stuff that's not super nice, and it definitely fits the not super nice check marks, you know, or boxes there. And looks like a good time. Okay, cool. So now all that stuff's out. I'm going to grab my, it's like an SOS pad on a 90 degree grinder. Prep all this stuff that way. Make sure I'm getting it down to the raw metal. If there's any oxidation on here, that kind of thing. This hole here looks a little rough. So I might get my die grinder and go on the ID of it. Not that I'm welding in there, but just to get stuff cleaned up. So I might do that, I might not. We'll see how the new fitting lays on here in a second. So for now, I'm gonna grab my 90 degree grinder and the SOS pad or whatever they're called and clean these surfaces up. All right, now that I got that kind of prepped, clean up my mess for a second. Okay, so I did end up going on the ID of that with the grinder, as you saw, just to give you guys a better idea of this. So the bung is pretty small flange-wise. A lot of times these things have a bigger flange. This one's pretty small, right? So on this side, that's why I clean the ID up on there. And then this one, the hole's a bit smaller. So just center that thing on there. Make sure if you're doing this at home, like I'm by no means a trained welder, but just some stuff I've learned, you gotta prep a good distance away from what you're welding, because it will pull in a lot of the stuff. Actually, like this little thing there is a little close yet, but it'll be okay. The next step is to wipe everything down with acetone. We just use normal acetone on a microfiber, actually, to wipe that area down. And then we used to use the blue towels, but the blue towels would occasionally leave pieces of the towel behind, which obviously would then just contaminate the weld. So I'm gonna wipe it down real quick and set these in place and get welding on them. We'll be right back. that's it. Got these welded on there. The casting being, because it's cast aluminum, being a little dirty, kind of caught up with me. I had to re-clean a spot in the back one there and weld over it. But aside from that, they're on there. They look pretty good. So I'm going to clean this thing up and call the customer, have him come get it and get it on the truck so he can bring this thing back down here and get it on the dyno with some crankcase vent. So if you like the video, hit that like button and subscribe for our future ones. If there's something else you want me to do a video of, leave a comment, let me know. Thanks for watching, guys.